Hello everyone, today I am going to show you a display 8x40 pixels using two colors and 3mm LED, green and red. Actually, you can adjust the width and height of the display, but means that you need to prepare more LEDs and take more time. Besides that, about the source code, I just verified for the display with 8x40 pixels. For other display variants, I am not sure that it displays correctly or not, but I will have one more video for verify and share some another display with different sizes. As you see here, the display very neat. I designed the PCB circuits for as flexible as possible, and this circuit sponsored by PCB White. So I want to thank PCB White for sponsoring this PCB. If you are going to make a project that needs PCB circuit, then PCB White is a good choice. In addition to PCB processing, PCB White also has some other services as high quality PCB, flexible PCB, PCB assembly, HMD stencils, CNC or 3D printing. All of those cases, PCB White can cover with reasonable price. You can check the description for get a link to get 10 PCBs free, only paying for shipping. Back to the PCB circuit, this PCB included one main board, two supports for bottom, two supports for left and right side. Every display have to have one main board and two supports for left and right side. This is minimum setup. Depends on your preference. You can increase the support for bottom to increase the width, and the support for left and right to increase the height. For the display that I am making in this video, I added more two supports for bottom. That means 3x16 pixels in white and 8x1 pixel in height. In addition, we need to another port for setup LED and align LED with this done correctly. After separate the circuits, then you need to wait in for the circuit. Finally, sew the components onto the circuit.
1 hour later.
Next, this part took me so many time. I need to handle for 384 legs of leg arm strength. So we need to bend this leg like this. The left leg bend to the left, the right leg bend to the right, and the middle leg bend down. But it needs to ensure that when we connect legs together, the legs must not talk together. So we need to wait for setup board like this to make a difference for the middle leg. Then just put the legs on it and bend them. And I have bent it for 4 hours. Then I remember that I need to check the bending direction and detected it wrong. As you see here, the right leg must be above, but this leg is below, so I need to fix it. I must to revert the lens that I bended, then bend it correctly again. Then I need to cut off the excess of the left legs. Just give about 6mm for the leg. After that, I need to connect them together for each leg. I use this bar. Then connect all the bars together to get the screen 8x48 pixels. After all, I committed repairing the screen 8x48 pixels. Besides that, I connected the bottom bars together. The connection is very simple. Just connect four signals, buttons on the top. and 2 hours studying at bottom together. For the connection on the right of the main power, don't connect this button. And now I need to connect the screen bottom power and the power at the left and the right side together. Ok, I'm done. Let me introduce to you this display. It uses ESP32C3. It has two cores, clock 116 MHz. Very suitable for the project like this. Need the high speed and compactness. It can connect directly with PC for upload code. Besides the ESP32, its real-time IC DS3231 and AIC serial to parallel 748C595. On the top, it has a USB Type-C and a header 1.25 mm for serial interface. This bar is very small, so it can only use this header. There is one more point that I want to share with you, that you must solder these buttons together. For the sub bar at the left and the right side, this point only applies for the top of the sub bar. That means if you have two sub-bars on the left and the right side, the top bar will be needed connecting using serial interface. So it needs one microcontroller as master. And I used module ESP32 from. I connected them together. About code for ESP32 from is very simple. Send to serial 2 anything that serial 0 receive, and show to serial 0 anything that serial 2 receives. Okay, you can send command help to get all command and usage. With the command you send to the display, the parameters must separate by space character and DN by NL and CR. Most of them are the functions that define in Adafruit GFX. You can check this library for detail. I will share you the commands that I added for the display. About clock display, when you send this command without parameter, the display will change to clock display mode with one parameter. The clock color will change to color that you send it. Okay, about successor with two parameters is function that defined in Adafruit GFX. With one parameter, it means successor or blink. With four parameters, it means on successor or blink mode. With mode E1, it means successor mode. With mode H2, it means blink mode.
Dried out.
About set display, this command for setting wide and high up the display. I will verify and share you in the next video. About set scroll, with one parameter it means up scroll, with two parameters it means up scroll but change the in-depth display. With four parameters, it means on scroll. And the last command is time. With six parameters, it means set time. Without parameter, it means get time.
Thank you.